Good morning students, welcome to today's English class. In the previous class, I read you half of the lesson, not exactly half, but two pages of this lesson. The name of the lesson is The King's Choice. Today, I'll be reading another half of this lesson. I hope you all have written the hard words three times and the meanings also in your notebook. If you have not written, just write them. We'll start with the reading now. Keep your textbook along with you and hear the pronunciation. Here we go. High up in the cooler air, the vulture flew. "Hurry along," he called. "The camel is not far off." But the lion could not hurry anymore. The hot sand had burned his paws. He could go no further. "Stop," he shouted to others. "Let us go back to the forest. I do not care to try camel meat." The Lion King's advisors were frightened. The forest was far behind them and they did not know how to get the lion back home. The leopard wanted to run away. The vulture wanted to watch and wait and eat the lion later on. But the clever fox thought of a plan. Off into the desert he ran, saying, "I will bring some help." After running for some time, the fox found the camel. The camel was indeed surprised to see him. "Hurry up, friend camel," said the fox. "Our king wants you at once." "Your king?" said the camel. "Who is that?" "I do not know any king. I only know my master, for whom I carry goods across the desert." "Our king, the lion, has killed your master," said the fox. "Now you are free and the lion has invited you to live at his court. Come along." The camel followed the fox. When the fox and the camel reached the lion's camp, the vulture and the leopard were surprised. Even the lion looked pleased in spite of his burnt paws. The camel was presented to the king. He agreed to serve the lion in return for a home at his court. "Get on the camel's back, your majesty," said the fox. "We will return home." The lion at once jumped onto the camel's back. His courtiers, the fox and the leopard, jumped up behind him, and with the vulture flying ahead as a guide, they set off on the long journey back to the forest. When the travelers reached the forest, they were all tired and hungry. The fox, the leopard, and the vulture looked at the camel. Then they looked at each other and smiled hungry smiles. They had brought the camel for the king's dinner. Now it was time for the feast. We will stop here. I'll read once again. Just hear it. High up in the cooler air, the vulture flew. "Hurry along," he called. "The camel is not far off." But the lion could not hurry anymore. The hot sand had burned his paws. He could go no further. "Stop," he shouted to the others. "Let us go back to the forest. I do not care to try camel meat." The Lion King's advisors were frightened. The forest was far behind them and they did not know how to get the lion back home. The leopard wanted to run away. The vulture wanted to watch and wait and eat the lion later on. But the clever fox thought of a plan. Off into the desert he ran, saying, "I will bring some help." After running for some time, the fox found the camel. The camel was indeed surprised to see him. "Hurry up, friend camel," said the fox. "Our king wants you at once." "Your king?" said the camel. "Who is that?" "I do not know any king. I only know my master, for whom I carry goods across the desert." "Our king, the lion, has killed your master," said the fox. "Now you are free, and the lion has invited you to live at his court. Come along." The camel followed the fox. When the fox and the camel reached the lion's camp, the vulture and the leopard were surprised. Even the lion looked pleased, in spite of his burnt paws. The camel was presented to the king. He agreed to serve the lion in return for a home at his court. "Get on the camel's back, your majesty," said the fox. "We will return home." The lion at once jumped onto the camel's back. His courtiers, the fox and the leopard, jumped up behind him. And with the vulture flying ahead as a guide, they set off on the long journey back to the forest. When the travelers reached the forest, they were all tired and hungry. The fox, the leopard, and the vulture looked at the camel. Then they looked at each other and smiled hungry smiles. So this much is enough for today's class. I don't think there are any hard words in today's reading. So I want you all to read this lesson, half of this lesson, from the beginning till the smiled hungry smiles. I want you all to read 2 times this lesson, and also I want you all to read the rest of the remaining lesson so that you will understand the story. Try to understand the story by yourself. In the next class, we will be reading the remaining part of this lesson, and then I will be explaining you this lesson in short. And then we will be discussing the moral of this story also. That is enough for today's class.